A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th September, on the front page you have "Hug each Kashmiri, build new paradise." So this is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi says, and he sees attempts from across the border to spread violence in the state. So he's spoken on that, and this is five leaders, including Mirwais, sign bonds to secure release. So Mirwais, Umar Farooq, and other leaders, they have signed bonds. They undertake not to indulge in any political activity after they are freed. Then even Kerala High Court, there is a case which has gone and it has held that right to have access to internet is part of the fundamental right to education as well as right to privacy under Article 21 of the Constitution. So this is the ruling of the Supreme Court. It is a petition filed by Fahima Shirin, a third semester BA English student of a college in Kerala. So he challenged her expulsion for not adhering to restrictions on the use of mobile phone. So she was expelled from the college. So even as per the rules of the girls' hostel, inmates were restrained from using mobile phones from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. So she said that she had protested against such restrictions. It was hampering their learning process as well. So High Court has upheld the college student's plea. Then below you have Keeladi findings traceable to 6th century BC report. So carbon dating has suggested that the cultural deposits here at an ancient Sangam age, at the Tamil Nadu archaeological site, this may be 300 years older than believed. So it is traceable to 6th century BC now. On page 9 you have India unlikely to meet Poshan Abhiyan targets, finds study. So the desired rate of improvement under the program is aspirational, it is said. So the nutritional indicators in 2022 as per global burden of diseases study is shown here. The percentage of stunting, which is the target, and projections as per the study are shown, and the gap which is there is shown. So percentage of stunting has to reduce to 25% is the target. Underweight has to reduce to 22.7%. But then what will be achieved as per the study is this. On editorial page, the first editorial is smoke of the vapor. So this is regarding e-cigarettes. It says the ban on e-cigarettes will require rigorous implementation to be effective. So e-cigarette smoking, it is called vaping because there are vapors which come out. So vaping had become a new norm which is now tried to be curbed. Central government has decided to ban e-cigarettes. So, but the editorial says there is a need for rigorous implementation for this ban to be effective. It is called ENDS, Electronic Nicotine Delivery Systems. And the second editorial is Israel undecided. So this is regarding Israeli elections. It has shown two parties getting, little less than majority, the left and the right wing, central left and the right wing as such. So this has put Israel in an indecisive mode. And it is said the present Prime Minister Netanyahu, he must step down to allow Israel to get a new stable government. So this is what the editorial says. And the lead article, Over the Hills and Far, Far Away. So this is regarding integration of the mountains with the mainstream. It is said this is unlikely under a unitary dispensation that promises a green bonus. So it talks about the Himalayan states. The 11 Himalayan states of India recently met in Dehradun demanding a green bonus or a payment for environment service they provide to the nation. So this is regarding this green rumors as such. And this is maths helped Einstein, it can help the economy too. So this is what this is actually a statement which had been made by a minister. We had discussed it, Mr. Piyush Goyal. So he said that maths has not helped Einstein. So, don't go into the maths of present economy, GDP calculations, like to be a $5 trillion economy, the country has to grow at this GDP rate. This he himself said that this is what you see on TV channels, but don't believe that. So this should be the growth rate, but we are at a very low growth rate. So, all those things are shown in news. So, This article says that the theory of relativity, for which Einstein is credited, is regarded as the pinnacle of mathematical elegance, more than a century since its formulation. So, of course, maths helps Einstein, is what this article tries to speak. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have this parlay coverage in which a question is raised and discussion takes place on that. So today the question is, can Hindi unite India? So the responses say that discarding diversity for purely majoritarian reasons. So different languages show diversity. It's the linguistic diversity of the country. If we discard that and impose Hindi on all to unite the country, you know, as such, for purely majoritarian reason, that majority are Hindi speakers, then it will be disastrous for the country, for the unity of the country too, and for peace in the country. On page 13, you have how the Modi may reveal mini deal. So US President Donald Trump and Prime Minister Narendra Modi are going to be together at this Howdy Modi meet in Texas, so in Houston. So it says this meet may announce a limited package of trade related agreements at this event in Houston, Texas. On international page, you have US drone strike kills 30, injures 40 in Afghanistan. So a US drone strike intended to hit the Islamic State hideout in Afghanistan killed at least 30 civilians resting after a day's labor in the fields. On business page, you have GST Council may review rates on auto sector. So easing annual returns filing procedure and nationalizing rates on lottery are also on agenda in the GST Council meeting, which is going to take place today. And this is room for rate cut as inflation under 4%. So this is RBI Governor Shaktikant Das saying that there is little scope for fiscal expansion because recent oil price rise also is there, but he says it will not impact inflation and there is room for rate cut. And on the last page, you have catch a cold and help scientists make new vaccines. So under a new model, volunteers will be infected with viruses or bacteria, and then this will be helping in making new vaccines. So they'll be infected under expert supervision with the infectious virus or bacteria, and then you can see this is called CHIM approach. So CHIM stands for controlled human infection model. So to speed up the process whereby scientists can quantify whether potential vaccine candidates can be effective in people and identify the factors that determine why some vaccinated people fall sick and others do not. And lastly, here you have UNICEF warns of emerging threats that young people face. So UNICEF says that climate change, mental illness, misinformation, etc. are the new emerging threats that young people face. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.